Back in February 2023, I started producing a mini-series of videos called The Myth of the Canadian Assault Rifle. These videos were specifically aimed at dispelling misinformation on Canada's new and existing gun laws, and the AR-15 in particular. Since then, I've received literally hundreds of inquiries from citizens, viewers, and even media outlets asking when the next video is going to be released and what topic it's going to address. The next video in the series was intended to focus on the logic and stats used to justify Canada's AR-15 ban. Up until now, the rationale provided by Justin Trudeau, Bill Blair, and other prominent members of the federal government has always been that there is some massive increase in the rate of murders being committed with so-called assault rifles. As a result of this, we've now reached a critical level, and the only logical response is to ban them all. What's really interesting about this particular narrative, though, is that although the Liberal Party regularly references these phantom stats and never-before-seen studies, they never actually cite any of them. In fact, if you conduct an online search right now for a citable source on the number of Canadians who've been killed with an AR-15, the fact is, you won't find one. These stats, that supposedly prove beyond any doubt that a total ban on modern rifles is the only way to protect Canadians from the unstoppable surge in violence, are conspicuously absent. You would think that if the numbers so conclusively prove their argument, the government would be all too happy to provide them. After all, why bother with impassioned speeches, sad stories about grieving widows, and constant reminders that you don't need an AR-15 to bring down a deer, when you can just post scientifically backed statistics that remove all doubt? Believe science. Remember that? Here's the strange part, though. Not only does the Canadian federal government not publish these stats, they aren't even researching them. In fact, the closest thing to a statistical analysis of how many Canadians have been killed with an AR-15 that you're going to find is this article here on Statistics Canada titled Number and Percentage of Homicide Victims by Type of Firearm Used to Commit the Homicide. Even this resource, which breaks firearms down into half a dozen different subcategories, fails to list this all-important stat. Instead, the closest we get is Fully Automatic Firearm, which, if you've seen my previous videos, you already know wouldn't apply to Canadian AR-15s because they're semi-automatic. Perhaps most telling of all, though, is the fact that the article is marked as archived. Why? Because the federal government stopped posting these stats in 2019, after firearms homicides actually fell by 7% in 2018. With all that said, the obvious reluctance of the Liberal Party to actually disclose or even acknowledge these numbers leads me to only one logical conclusion, that the stats do not support their policy. For that reason, I decided to investigate on my own, and on April 22, 2023, I submitted an ATIP request to Canada's Federal Police Force, the RCMP. For those not familiar with ATIP, this is Canada's Access to Information and Privacy Service, what many folks would refer to as FOI, or Freedom of Information. My request was simple. How many murders have been committed in Canada using an AR-15 pattern rifle between 1970, January 1st, and 2022, December 31st? If possible, please include the basic details of each. Date, city, name of offender. For those of you wondering why I asked them to include details where possible, this was to allow me the ability to fact-check their numbers rather than just take them at their word. Before we go any further, I'm just going to take a minute and mention, in the following correspondence, I've gone ahead and obfuscated the names and contact information of the parties at both the RCMP and the Information Commissioner that I dealt with. So what happened after I filed my ATIP request? Well, about a week and a half later, I got a generic form letter response confirming the RCMP received my request and advising me they could only release information related to myself and that they required a 30-day extension because of the large volume of records they needed to search. I wasn't super surprised about the delay. I'm sure there are a lot of records between 1970 and 2022, so fair enough. What did strike me as odd, though, was the comment about limiting information to what pertained to me personally when what I was requesting was statistics on public information. With that being the case, I decided to reply to them the same day requesting clarification. The very next day, I received a brief response stating they were proceeding with the request, but may release limited information. No further action was required on my part, so it was just the waiting game. After several more weeks of silence, on June 12th, I finally decided to request an update. A full week later, the RCMP responded, indicating they were very busy and experiencing lengthy delays. Naturally, no timeline was available, despite their legal obligation to provide one. Instead, I was invited to contact the Information Commissioner of Canada and file a complaint. So I did. On June 22nd, I submitted my complaint to the Office of the Information Commissioner. Nearly 2 weeks later, I received a reply asking me to provide a dearth of information related to my inquiry and concerns. Later that same day, I responded with the requested information. 5 days later, I contacted them again, asking them to confirm if they received the information package. The following day, they responded indicating they had, and that they had my complaint and it was being actioned. Finally, on July the 12th, the Office of the Information Commissioner CC'd me on a notice to the RCMP. The notice stated that they'd received my complaint, reviewed the details, and were proceeding with an investigation under Section 7. It's now July 22nd, 2023. As of today, I am still waiting for an update regarding both my ATIP request and the subsequent Access to Information Act complaint. On the one hand, I do understand that asking for the number of murders committed with a particular type of firearm over a 50-year span is definitely a daunting task, even if that number is almost certainly extremely low. Unfortunately, I really don't see much alternative here. If the federal government wants to target AR-15 specifically, then realistically, my request has to focus on the same style of firearm. Likewise, I was concerned that selecting a shorter period of time would simply result in anti-gun folks accusing me of being too narrow in my analysis or intentionally cherry-picking a period of time where I already knew gun crime was at a historic low. Moreover, as regards the RCMP and the federal government as a whole, I definitely feel like if you're going to tell people you're making decisions based on science and statistics, you better be ready to show your work when they call you out on it. One would have to assume that if what they're saying is true and gun policy in this country really is driven by statistics like these, then those same statistics should not only be publicly available upon request, but that they should already have been collected and prepared for this specific purpose. The fact that the same government that claims we're under siege from so-called assault rifles is neither willing nor able to provide any data on the number of murders committed with them, the frequency with which they occur, or even if they're on the rise, even when specifically asked for it, speaks volumes about just how little role statistics actually play in Canadian gun control.